Hi, Mom. Yeah. No, can you pick up Chris after school? Yeah, I'm at the doctor's.
Mrs. Harris?
Describe your symptoms.
Hang on. Stress, headaches, nausea. Well, I work on Saturdays.
And how long has this been?
Equanimity. Balance your lifestyle.
Good morning. This is the Valder Beebe Show, broadcasting live from Dallas, Texas. Who do I have in the studio with me?
So my name is Dr. Purvi Parikh. I'm an allergist.
And I'm Dr. Carrie Sennett. I'm the president and CEO of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation of America, a not-for-profit organization dedicated to serving people with asthma and allergic disease.
Well, I want to thank you so much. I want to let my audience know that there is some kind of relief for you if you're an allergy sufferer. But we're going to tell you the cities probably where you're suffering the most. You probably already know. If we could talk with you, Dr. Parikh, tell us about allergies.
So allergies is your own body or your immune system's reaction to something foreign. So your immune system decides that it doesn't like something and you have a very hypersensitive reaction to it. So you can get itchy eyes, stuffy nose, breathing problems, and seasonal allergies are named that way because they're specific pollens that you can react to, and those come out only in certain seasons of the year.
Okay, Dr. Sennett, let me ask you about the Asthma Allergy Foundation. You guys probably have a lot of work this time of year.
We do. The Asthma and Allergy Foundation is a not-for-profit whose mission is to improve the quality of life for people with asthma and allergic disease. And one of the ways that we do that, one of the things that we do is produce this annual report on spring allergy capitals, which is our effort to, number one, raise awareness of the problem of allergy, which affects 50 million Americans, but also to help people understand that there are variations across the country in terms of the places that people live, and to help them understand what they can do to deal with the problem of allergy wherever they live.
Do you have any those that rank the highest with allergies?
We do. Our report, which is available at allergycapitals.com, ranks the 100 largest cities in the country on three factors. We look at pollen counts. Pollen's the bad actor, as Dr. Parikh says, that really drives allergic symptoms. We look at medication use that helps us understand how many people are affected and how severely they're affected. And we look at the availability of board-certified allergists, physicians like Dr. Parikh who are specialized in helping people with allergy manage their symptoms, manage their condition. So we score these three factors, and then we combine those into a single score for each city, and then we rank the cities based on that score.
Dr. Parikh, let me ask you, does allergies get worse some years or better some years?
Yes, definitely. There are a lot of factors that go into it. One are the pollen counts. From year to year, they vary based on weather patterns, how mild or severe our winters are. And then also the individual themselves, if you move somewhere, if you move from a more rural setting into a city or vice versa, some people get worse depending on how your own body will react to it.
Dr. Sennett, let me ask you, I'm in what you call the Southwest. How's the city's ranking in the Southwest for allergies?
Well, I think what we see is that the sort of most challenging places typically are in the South or Southeast, Mid-Atlantic. Jackson, Mississippi is, again, the most challenging place for people in the United States. Dallas is 27th in our ranking, so it's not in the top 10, but it is a place where there are challenges. And again, if you have allergy to the pollen in Dallas, it doesn't matter whether you're 27th or 95th, you have a real problem, and we want to be able to help you solve that problem.
The Allergy Foundation, that was my next question. What relief can people find. And also, too, if you weren't an allergy sufferer and you're a new allergy sufferer, I'm a new one. I've never had allergies, but this year I have allergies. So what relief is there for us?
Well, let me speak to a couple of things that are relatively simple, and let Dr. Parikh speak to some of the things that I think everyone needs to know. First of all, there's a lot of information at allergycapitals.com, which is where our report is, but also links to other content on our parent website, aafa.org. You know, the things that people can do that are very simple have to do with reducing their exposure to pollen. So don't go outdoors in the morning when pollen counts are highest. When you come in from outside, take off your shoes, change your clothes, take a shower, wash all the pollen away. Keep pollen out, keep your windows closed in your home, in your car, use an air conditioner. Those are very simple things, and as I say, there's a lot more at the website. But on the medical side, Dr. Parikh.
Right, and especially if you're a new sufferer, it can be confusing. Is this really allergies? Am I having asthma? Well, you know, what's going on? So one thing we can recommend is that you do see a board-certified allergist, because then you can be diagnosed and appropriately treated depending on what your symptoms are. And the treatment varies. I mean, usually we like to get people on medications early in the season so it prevents them from suffering. But anything from antihistamine tablets to antihistamine and nasal steroid sprays, one of which is Dymista, which we frequently use. But some people do develop coughing, wheezing, skin symptoms. So it's important to figure out what your triggers are and what the best medications are for you, because you may need inhalers. You may even develop a touch of asthma during the season. So it's definitely worth investigating.
Dr. Parikh, Dr. Sinnett talked about a list of board-certified allergists. How do we choose an allergist rather than they're just in our plan?
Right. So that itself is always a challenge. You know, the insurance companies do dictate from time to time, but there are resources. So the American Academy of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology and the American College of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology are two national societies. So you can find allergists there. You can find additional information there. And then, of course, always speak with your primary care physician, because they can refer you to one of their colleagues who they feel may be best for you.
Dr. Sinnett, your survey makes us aware of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation of America. Tell us, though, how many people do you think are suffering from allergies in the United States?
Well, the national statistics suggest that there are about 50 million Americans who suffer from allergic disease of some sort. And so that's a huge group of people who are suffering. And, you know, I think we certainly think of allergies. We need to recognize that allergies can be profoundly life-limiting, that the individual who sneezes occasionally is one thing, but there are people who have symptoms for 3 months that are very severe, very, very substantially interfere with their ability to do the things that they enjoy doing, may interfere with their ability to work, or children, their ability to go to school. And this happens for many of them, not just in the spring, but also in the fall. So it's a very large group of people, many of whom really, really do suffer. And part of our goal, and we thank you for the opportunity, is just to help people understand how big this problem is and how great the need is to deal with it.
I'm sure allergy sufferers all over who are listening to this agree with you 100%. Dr. Sinnett, Dr. Parikh, I want to thank you so much for giving us that information. And once again, what's the website, Dr. Sinnett?
It's allergycapitals.com. One word, and that's where the report is, as well as links to other sites that provide much more information, including our website, aafa.org.
Well, thank you guys for being my medical experts today on the Valder Beebe Show. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.